are five things. I think first, this clear understanding of what my brand stands for and what does it not stand for. Therefore, if these new stakeholders wish to push my brand in directions that I do not stand for, I must stop that, prevent that from happening. The second, of course, is that because of this notion that we live in a world which is always on, because of the notion that every individual is a producer of content, because of the notion that one individual means one network because he or she has his own set of people. Because of all of this, what is necessary for the brands to do is to do a proper audit of who are its customers, who are its main customers, and what is it that they use. TV is okay when you are looking at selling Lifebuoy soap, you need crores of people to buy. But if you are selling a handcrafted shoe, where do I get onto the social media network? And so on. So first, be very clear about what your brand is, what it is not. Second, make sure you have defined who your intended target is. Having decided that, then decide the channel. It is just because social media is a fashion does not mean it is necessarily right for your brand. Just because FM is back and very cheap does not mean it is right for your brand. So I think these three are the determinants of success in the future, because as I said, the more the change, the better it is for you to stick to the basics. And the basic is this: I must know what my brand stands for, what it doesn't stand for. I must know who my target is and where they are, what are they listening to, what are they hearing. And therefore, I need to be there. So this connect between what are target customers, what are they interested in. Most of the brands that have been successful are brands that have connected themselves to things in the social life of their customers. It is obviously the world's most valuable brand, and that's Coke. And if you look at, they do advertising, but they get far greater ROI on doing Coke Studio. While they are doing Coke Studio, which is like a signature event, they are also doing face-to-face things. They have a cricket league among schools. While they are doing cricket league among schools, they also do this online-offline merger. I don't know if you saw this famous thing about India-Pakistan fingers. So if you then realize, then you look at, take a view of what that brand is doing. It's connecting to people where people are. If people have started using smartphones and are used to now, you know, manipulating media through by touch, they are there. If children are interested in cricket and in professional work, in professional training, they are there. And they are there in, as indie music increases, then they are there with indie music. So it's a beautiful way of orchestrating being where the customer is. Social media is not an option to traditional media, but it certainly is a viable alternative when you are small. You of course have to start from your objective. If your objective is to stay localized, social media will work brilliantly. Social media, the advantages are that the brand gets spoken about by people who use social media. So if you know very clearly who is the target you're looking for, you can use social media to reach to certain people and multiply that. Because one of the things we say is each person is actually a network. So if you reach the right people, they will immediately start talking about your brand to other friends. That's what we've seen time and again, that people talk about brands not because they are interested in your brand, but because they are interested in their friends. That is the key. So if you have a particular advantage, a particular unique proposition about your brand, and if even a handful of people are convinced about it, they will multiply it elsewhere. So the key is not social media, the key is using social media to reach a very well-defined target.